So it's an exciting day of planning. Today, this is the fourth video of four. So if you're gonna wanna see the 70-200 f2.8, then make sure you stay tuned. This is of course a little bit of an interesting move from Canon because they already do actually have a 70-200 f2.8. And with this particular one, you actually have two choices. You can either have it in the black version or the gray version, depending on kind of what you want to do with. Of course, when it came to the original 70-200 f2.8, it was actually hit upon quite a bit with the fact that it didn't actually have an internal zoom, which means the weather sealing can actually be compromised. When it comes to this particular 70-200 though, however, it is all internal, very similar to what you got out of the 2040-105 f2.8 that was released last year. The added benefit of this is, of course, this actually comes from the Canon Z range glass, so it is actually designed very much with video in mind. You've actually got the capability there of adding a electronic zoom function to the side of the lens, just like you did with the 2040-105 f2.8, which makes this an all-round well-rounded piece of glass. But let's get to it. You've probably seen it in the other four videos. I've literally got all of these lenses all in one day, so let's get to it, shall we? And now, of course, we've got the 70-200 f2.8 from Canon. Like I said, you can get this in grey as well as black. Of course, you've got a lens hood. It does actually have access to be able to control your circular polarizers or variable NDs right there. There is a button on this side in order to release it. And then all you have to do is find the point and click it on. The lens can either be at the top or the bottom, depending kind of like what you want to do. And just actually show that. There you go. So you can actually have it on the bottom, which is the best place for it anyway. And of course, you do actually have the 70-200. As you can probably tell, it looks very similar to what you would actually got out of the 2040-105mm camera. You've got a lot of switches here, including a stabilizer with three modes on it, a manual focus switch and a focus control switch there, which allows you to focus to from 25 millimeters to infinity, all the full range there. You've then of course got yourself an aperture ring, which is really nice. And again, an iris switch here, which you just pull down, switch to A, and now you can control the aperture inside of it. I do, and I know you've heard this probably four times today, if you've looked at all four, do prefer to use the aperture wheel because it's really quite nice. You got a really nice focus flow here as well, which is sort of a 90 degree kind of like quick zoom in, zoom out, which you're expecting out of a video lens anyway, and a really nice manual focus ring here, as well as that custom dial on the front, which you can set to pretty much anything you want. You've actually got the ability to put the electronic zoom in the side here, which allows you to control both the zoom in and the manual focus as well, which is actually pretty quite cool. And then last but not least, you've actually got yourself a tripod collar, which you can use with or without, entirely up to you. It's a nice little setup, really, and quite light, but also, you know, decently sized as well. It's a all-round kind of beautiful lens and kind of what you're expecting the EOS R 70-200 to really look like. Let's get to shooting. Through just doing some street photography in and around Cardiff, you've got to admit it's actually a really sharp lens, but also the ergonomics and the control of just being able to zoom in was an absolute dream. This lens, I must admit, when I was going into it, I thought, why are they doing another 70-200? Because they've already got that small one. However, it makes sense when you think about it. Everything in this lens is internal rather than an external zoom, which makes it that much better for weather sealing, but also what people really expect out of a 70-200 as well. Of course, with the release of the 2040-105 last year, this lens kind of follows in its footsteps with a very similar sort of design and feel to it. The lens is beautiful to use, and yes, it is designed for videographers, however, it will be very comfortable in a photographer's hand as well, and I think the video kind of zoom in capabilities of this actually make me feel a lot better to like zoom in and out of than what you would have actually had in a normal 70-200. And this is where I would say this is actually one of the most comfortable 70-200s that I've ever really actually used. And that's saying something. Last thing to mention before we get into the conclusion is the image stabilization handheld was pretty awesome, actually, and makes it really useful for like dock situations. Just having a much cheaper and more lightweight body on you, going around, shooting things, and still getting that stable shot. It's pretty cool.
Whilst also having that image quality that Canon is so well known for.
First thing I'm noticing whilst using this lens is that it's very similar to the 2040-105, where it has that very small sort of like zoom in distance. It's literally 90 degrees, so it feels very reactive. And for events photographers and videographers, I feel like it would be ideal for that. But yeah, let's keep going. Just coming to the end of just actually shooting with this lens now. This 70-200Z lens is really quite nice. I love the 90 degree zoom in, zoom out function, that's fantastic. The image stabilization on the lens is pretty awesome. It's nice, lightweight, to the point where I can shoot it with just one hand if I wanted to. It's also got the ability to put on that zoom. It's also got the ability to put on that zoom drive, which is kind of cool. See if I can test it out in a second. But overall, really quite impressed. It's nice to see Canon kind of like go back on themselves just a little bit and produce a lens that's pretty awesome across the board, to be honest with you. Testing out with video, and again, this is more of a video lens here. I must admit, for documentary, for just general day-to-day shooting, absolutely incredible. In fact, this with the 2040-105, I would think would actually be an absolute killer setup, just in general. Anyway, if you like this video, make sure you like, follow, subscribe if you want to see more. Have a good day.